Ace hat anscheinend ein Video hochgeladen, ob VPNs, also virtuelle private Netzwerke, könnt ihr ja über hunderte Anbieter euch nehmen, da könnt ihr euch ja woanders einwählen, einfache Lobbys in Warzone geben. Lass uns das mal angucken. Und bevor wir uns angucken, darf Ronny kurz zu Ende erzählen.
Ich bin fertig. Aber dann hat Shabby seinen Stream angemacht und der Tag war gerettet.
So wie immer. Du hast ein SF vor deinem Namen, Dominik, weil ich dir einen Sub gekauft habe. Arschloch.
And I've seen many claims that you can easily use a VPN to get absolute bot lobbies where you can play bottom of the barrel players, and then there's tons of people that are accusing many streamers of using VPNs in order to get easier lobbies. So I was really curious. I wanted to go in, put this to the test for myself to see if this is actually true. Does using a VPN actually give you consistently easier lobbies? No, right up front here, I'm not going to share exactly how to do this, exactly which VPN to use or how to use it or anything. For those that are really interested, it's not that hard to figure out how to do this. I just personally don't want to be spreading the steps for.
Bei aller Liebe, dann brauchen wir auch kein Geheimnis draus machen. Also wie man VPN benutzt, weiß jeder. Und wo du dich einwählen musst, weiß mittlerweile auch jeder. Du nimmst eine von den ganz fünf Nationen, wo am wenigsten gute Spieler verfügbar sind. Das ist Kasachstan, Usbekistan. Du kannst Nordamerika nehmen, weil da einfach die Spieleranzahl so groß ist, weshalb das SBMM dort nicht so reinkickt. Oder du nimmst einfach zwei andere Länder, wo eher wenig Spieler unterwegs sind.
For this at least. Instead, I just wanted to see if this actually works and see if a lot of the claims I've been seeing thrown around about VPNs are actually true. And before we get into the results of my tests and everything, I just wanted to point out this was not a like full-on scientific study. This wasn't like the SBMM study I did way back in the day. This was more so just a quick test to see if I noticed any trends. So I'm not saying you should take this pretty limited data here as gospel, but I did notice some interesting trends with this that I wanted to share with you guys. And hopping right into it, one of the big misconceptions about using a VPN for easier lobbies in Warzone is that it's going to give you a significantly higher ping. You would think if you're using a VPN to spoof your location and effectively place yourself in, let's just say, Africa, then all of your packets and data would have to travel all the way to Africa and then to the server and then back to Africa and then back to you, which would massively increase your ping
and it
would
likely lead
to a pretty unplayable experience. So even if you were getting easier lobbies, it probably wouldn't be worth it because the experience would just be terrible. It turns out there is a specific VPN or maybe even a few VPNs out there that will spoof your location for the matchmaking system.
Wovon er redet übrigens, Leute, ist NordVPN. Das ist, glaube ich, einer der größten oder der größte VPN-Anbieter auf der Welt.
But it doesn't route all of your data through that. It's apparently just the data
Ja,
needed
müsste einer
to
der größten
confuse the
sein.
matchmaking
Auch so
system
den
enough,
ganzen
so it doesn't know what
Ja.
your actual location is. So that's the first thing I found while using this VPN, is I'm still getting the same ping that I would get without a VPN, even though the game thinks I'm playing from a completely different continent.
Das ist
So let's
krass.
first hop into the results from my solos test. So I was using just solo game modes. I played 5 games without a VPN and then 5 games with the VPN. And keep in mind, I did this before peak hours. It wasn't quite at peak hours yet. Just so you guys know, if you are playing during the peak hours, it seems like the skill-based matchmaking system is much more strict during that time, just because the player pool is much larger at that point. So if you're somebody with really good stats, you're gonna have much more difficult lobbies during peak hours. But just before peak hours here, without a VPN, after 5 games of solos, I was actually quite surprised to see the average KD in those lobbies was right around 1. It was never below 1, but it ranged from exactly 1.0 up to 1.05. And I honestly thought these lobbies would be more difficult without a VPN, but like I said, I think this is just due to the fact that I'm playing in off-peak hours, or maybe they cut down on SBMM in solo modes. I'm not too sure about that. But in either case, the average KD out of these 5 matches was 1.02, which seems pretty normal here. Now, for my next 5 games, where I...
Also bei dieser Warzone-KD wäre ich immer ein bisschen vorsichtig. Also ich selber habe in Warzone eine 1,5er-KD. Das klingt jetzt, finde ich, auch super schlecht. Aber also ich persönlich hätte keinen Bock auf 80 Spieler zu treffen, die so spielen wie ich. Bei mir liegt es aber auch daran, ich mache ja unter anderem zum Beispiel jetzt auch solche Challenges wie mit dem Schild, wo ich dann vielleicht auch im Gulag lande. Manche Squad-Runden wird man halt drei, viermal wiedergekauft, weil man sich irgendwie opfert. Also die Stats von professionellen Warzone-Spielern sind da, finde ich, interessanter, weil die sind ja bei einer 4er-5er-KD und die droppen halt auch jede Runde 4 bis 10 Kills.
turn my VPN on, we can definitely see a trend of easier games. Now, three of those five games were still right around that 1KD range, like from 0.97 to 0.99. So those lobbies really weren't significantly different than the lobbies I was experiencing when I wasn't using a VPN. However, two of those games that I got were 0.83 and 0.85 KDs.
Traum.
And while that might not seem like it's too much below one, that really is a significant difference. Just like if you were comparing a 1KD lobby to a 1.2 KD lobby. 1.2 KD might not seem very intimidating, but you will notice the competition is significantly better in a 1.2 KD lobby compared to a 1 KD lobby.
Im Multiplayer
it's the same
für
story
sterben.
With that 0.83 or 0.85 KD. On average, at least, your enemies are going to be quite a bit easier to deal with. And on average, out of these five games, the kill-death ratio was 0.92 in these lobbies. So far, it already looks like the VPN does work a little bit. It's not like it's giving you the absolute bottom-of-the-barrel lobbies or anything. You're not getting like a 0.5 KD lobby, but on average, at least, you're getting easier lobbies with the VPN on compared to with it off. However, that's just for solo modes. A little bit later in the evening, where I was kind of on the tail end of peak hours, but this is more so during peak hours, I decided to do a few more tests with the quads game mode just to see how that would be different from solos, and this is where the results got quite a bit more interesting. Now for this test, I only tested three games without and three games with the VPN, so not quite as much of a sample size here, but I just wanted to do a really quick test to see if it was any different in quads. And without the VPN, as you can see here, the average team KD of those three games was 1.28, which is quite high. These are diamond lobbies. Every single game I played here is a diamond lobby. And again, just to remind you, it might not look that intimidating if you're
1.35er KD Durchschnitt ist fast meine. Also es sind nur Squads mit meinem Skill Level dann.
But keep in mind, the average team KD lobby, I don't think I've ever seen one above 1.4. So anything like 1.2 and up is a diamond lobby, and that's a very difficult lobby to be playing in. So the average team KD from these lobbies was 1.28. Whereas when I turned that VPN on, what I noticed here is I was still getting an average team KD above 1, but these lobbies weren't nearly as difficult as when I wasn't using the VPN.
Boy.
So out of these three games, the average team KD of the lobby was 1.09. So with this one, it definitely helps more noticeably than with solo modes, or at least it did when I did my testing. This could have had to do with just the time of the day. Like I said, I was a little bit more during the peak hours while doing this testing.
Also ich kann verstehen, dass Ace keinen Bock hat, das so zu testen, wie er das SBMM getestet hat. Da hat er es ja mit Drifter, Jagged, True Game Data und noch jemandem über Wochen getestet. Es sind ja unzählige hunderte von Stunden reingegangen. Aber interessant wäre, wenn man das in den Squads einmal überprüft, zu diesen drei typischen Uhrzeiten, wo man die Unterschiede hat. Also morgens sind ja eigentlich die entspanntesten Lobbys. Dann würde ich sagen, mittelmäßig zur Mittagszeit und dann nochmal abends zur Peakzeit. Vielleicht auch einfach mal Freitag, Samstagabend. Ich bin mir 100% sicher, dass selbst mit einem VPN man Freitag, Samstagabend deutlich schwere Lobbys hat als mit VPN, aber morgens.
Whereas with the solos testing, it was before peak hours. But it seems pretty clear here that a VPN can absolutely help you get easier lobbies on a more consistent basis. Having said that though, in my experience so far, using a VPN doesn't necessarily give you bot lobbies. And what I mean by bot lobbies is where you're playing the lowest of the low skill players. This is what a lot of people claim that the VPNs do. And who knows, maybe I'm connecting to the wrong server, or I just haven't tweaked and played around with this enough to find out how to do that, which I'm personally not really interested in doing in the first place. But as far as I can tell at least, the VPN works, but not quite to the same extent as a lot of people seem to be claiming. Now, let's get into the really juicy part of this. For those that watch my live streams on Twitch, I don't really stream Warzone a whole lot, and the reason for this is when I play Battle Royale modes in Warzone, on average, I get a terrible connection experience.
Yo.
Not only do I get quite a high ping, I also get constant stutters and rubber banding, and you can probably see it in the gameplay every now and then I get stutters and stuff, although the gameplay I record tends to be the better gameplays where I'm not getting as many stutters, so you don't see it at its worst here. But something really interesting I've been noticing over the past several weeks or so is these stutters and stuff, they only really appear when I play Battle Royale modes, whereas when I play Plunder, I don't really get these, or I don't get them nearly as often. And I was really wondering why that would be the case. It's not like it should be performing really any different connection-wise between the two modes. However, based on every test that I've done in the past, it doesn't look like there's any strict skill-based matchmaking in Plunder, whereas there is skill-based matchmaking in regular Battle Royale modes.
Das allein zu hören, ne, dass in diesem Noob-Modus in Plunder, wo jeder von euch schon mal gespielt hat, wo auch echt Anfänger einfach nur rumlaufen, dass das SBMM in dem Sinne dort überhaupt nicht aktiv ist. Und dann die Aussage von David von der Haar vor Cold War, als er gesagt hat, Ping ist immer King. Also egal wie das SBMM ist, es wird immer um den Ping gehen. Und das ist das, was so hart einfach nervt, dass man die gesamte Spiel-Experience, dass die einfach beschissen ist für normale Spieler. Nicht, weil die Gegner alle schwitzen wie Shappy, sondern weil dieser scheiß Ping andauernd auf 150, 200 geht. Mittlerweile bin ich an dem Punkt, wo mich der Ping mehr stört als die Gegner.
And what I found while testing out this VPN is when the VPN was on, I didn't get nearly as many of these stutters. My connection was much more smooth and consistent on average than when I wasn't using the VPN. And what I suspect this is an indication of is that the skill-based matchmaking system may be sacrificing your connection quality and connection experience to get you in a better skill-matched lobby rather than putting you in the lobby that will give you the absolute best connection experience possible, which should always be the case. Now again, I did want to remind you guys that this wasn't a full-on scientific study. This is more so just going off of my anecdotal experience, and this was a very limited test that I've done so far. I will definitely continue to do more testing on this and with more focus on the connection experience, because that wasn't my initial goal going into this test. But honestly, at this point, at least when I move over to PC, because that's something I didn't mention, this particular method of using a VPN without getting a significantly higher ping currently only seems to work on PC. But when I'm playing on PC going forward, I honestly feel like I'm going to be using a VPN just so I can get a better and more consistent connection.
Das könnte ich live im Stream und in dem Video jedem erklären und sagen, ab jetzt, Leute, würde ich Warzone auf dem PC spielen. Tue ich ja jetzt noch nicht. Ich muss überlegen, ob ich das in Zukunft mache, wenn der neue PC hier ist. Ich habe ja schon von Ronny und so gehört, ich kann im Prinzip ganz easy am PC spielen und einfach meinen Controller nehmen. Mein neuer PC ist ja auch im Prinzip ein reiner Gaming-Rechner auch, von der Leistung her. Wenn ich jedem erklären würde, ich spiele über ein VPN, damit ich eine bessere Verbindung habe, Leute, wie viel Hasskommentare ich kriegen würde, dass ich ja nur gegen Bots spielen will. Boah. Experience.
So yeah, that pretty much wraps it up for the testing and the results that I got that I wanted to share with you guys. And at this point, I definitely want to continue exploring this further just to see how it affects that connection experience, as well as just some more detailed testing on how much it helps with the skill-based matchmaking system. But overall, as far as I've been able to see here, it does look like using this type of VPN can throw a wrench in the matchmaking system. And I don't know exactly how it works, but it just seems to confuse the system enough to throw you into the best connection lobby rather than the best skill match lobby. And it doesn't necessarily seem to be a solution to get absolute bot lobbies as if you're reverse boosting or anything. But instead, it just seems like the game is going to throw you into a lobby as if skill-based matchmaking didn't exist. I would still say that the time of day that you're playing in for your region is much more important when it comes to how easy your lobbies are going to be. If you play earlier in the day, way before peak hours like a lot of streamers do, then you're more likely to run into easier lobbies with or without a VPN, although the VPN might make it more consistent. Now, as for my final thoughts on this topic before we wrap it up, I just wanted to briefly share how I feel about streamers or YouTubers using VPNs while playing Warzone. And with this, as far as I can tell so far at least, using a VPN isn't nearly as bad as reverse boosting or joining up on a Smurf account to get super easy lobbies. Like you saw, it doesn't look like that using a VPN is going to guarantee you super, super easy lobbies or anything. Instead, it seems like the matchmaking system just now puts you into the best connection experience possible. And as a result, I honestly don't have that much of an issue with streamers or YouTubers using a VPN as long as they're not hiding it, as long as they're open about it, as long as they're honest about it. I don't really see much of an issue here.
Das, ich verstehe, was Ace damit sagen will, aber was mich hier so stört ist, muss ich dann jedes Mal, wenn ich in Zukunft am PC Warzone spiele, am Anfang vom Stream, nach einer Stunde, nach zwei Stunden, nach drei Stunden, eine offizielle Aussage tätigen und sagen, liebe Zuschauer, ich spiele gerade auf einem VPN-Server, das ist doch auch Bullshit.
Ich glaube, er meint damit, dass du, wenn du gefragt wirst, da ehrlich bist.
Ja, okay, damit habe ich kein Problem in dem Fall.
Was, aber das meint er damit?
Was mich so stört, ist, dass mittlerweile ja wegen diesem scheiß SBMM sich jeder, der auch nur eine gute Runde erspielt, erklären muss. Also auch ja. Die Nukes. Ich meine, jeder kann live den Stream nachverfolgen. Einer hat vor ein paar Tagen einen Kommentar geschrieben, dass ich die ganzen Nukes in dem neuen Modus ja nur mache, weil ich mit Absicht immer die 5 schlechtesten Spieler aus dem Stream einlade.
Danke.
Ja, vor allem,
was ich. Mich hat Kompliment.
Was
komisch, dass zwei der schlechtesten Spieler beide einen Nuke gespielt haben.
Was ich so schlimm daran finde, du schreibst den und sagst, interessante, kannst du dir den Stream mir angucken, ob ich hier jemals gecheckt habe, wer welche KD hat. Die Antwort, die du leider kriegst, ist dann immer die gleiche: Arschloch. Es ist immer so.
Tournaments are a completely different story. If you're playing in a tournament for money, I really do feel like the tournament should have rules in place that forces you to show your geographic location while you're playing, because that'll show whether or not you're using a VPN. Oh, when it's just for content or entertaining your audience, it's fine. But when there's money on the line and some people have access to the VPN and others don't have access, then you're suddenly in an unfair situation and people are being hurt in the process for not having access to that VPN. Of course, those are just my thoughts on this. I'd like to know in the comment section below, what did you guys think about these results?
Ja, also um das zu umgehen, haben wir ja extra gesagt beim Warzone-Turnier, das Trio muss immer mir joinen.